Hey guys, I'm Callie Lewis. We are at the CE Line Shows in New York. Welcome, Gary Shapiro.
Welcome, Callie Lewis. I am so excited to be back here with you.
I am excited to have you as well. I'm a little embarrassed, though, because you're seeing us pre-show. Now, you guys are watching this on Wednesday, but today is actually Tuesday, so we're like going in time.
By the time people are watching this will be beautiful. You'll all be done. John won't be back there pretending he's working.
John's just pretending back there.
Moving things from one place.
So the boys are setting up while we have Gary because he's so busy this year and there's so much going on at the CE Line shows that we couldn't grab you tomorrow. So why is it so busy? Things seem to be going well.
Well, this is an amazing week it's turning out to be. The CE Week has evolved into something that's really, really growing fast, very, very big. It's a record attendance, a record number of exhibitors sold out, 150. The press registration's over 1,000. We have over 5,000 people coming. This was started with basically nothing a few years ago, and now it's an opportunity for a lot of companies to show their products, to deal with important media like you, and to get the word out.
Oh, you just called us important. Awesome.
You're beyond important. You're a super platinum ultra star, sit at the front of the plane important.
Oh, I wish. Well, I'm so glad to hear that it's growing and expanding. We're definitely, from our point of view, seeing a lot more, you know, smaller companies kind of getting their feet wet into the show and being able to kind of get a lot of exposure, which is fantastic.
Absolutely. And I also think we're seeing something in time which is different. There was a little bit of a lag after HDTV and some of the hardware areas. And certainly, you know, in two categories seem to dominate, smartphones and tablets. That's where all the action was. Now the action is in so many areas. We're seeing a lot with automobiles, the connected car. We're seeing 4K Ultra is coming really big and really fast, and I'm very excited about it.
So is 3D gone because of 4K? Or, I'm sorry, Ultra HD?
Well, 3D to me was always a feature. I think the ESPN announcement was an important, significant announcement. I think you'll see generally a lot more focus on Ultra 4K, which, by the way, will include 3D visibility, and 3D still is in most higher-end sets sold. It's just not what a lot of people thought it would be. And I think it hurt the industry credibility a little bit, but I think when people see Ultra 4K, they'll say, that's what I want, I don't need to wear the glasses, and it's beautiful, and where do I get one?
I have never been huge on 3D. I just thought, you know, it was kind of a fad. I've never been really into it. So I was super excited to see Ultra HD. I mean, you guys, if you haven't actually gotten your eyes on them, they are beautiful. So any of them, just go pick one. Just go look at it at Fry's or Best Buy or wherever you can find one.
The wallpaper people are in a panic because there's, I mean, all these flat screens that look so much better than wallpaper or paint.
Yeah. Now, I didn't properly introduce you because everybody knows who you are, but for those people who might not, Gary is the CEO and the president of the CEA. Plus, you are the author of the best-selling New York Times bestseller book, Ninja Innovation. And you have to finish out the name of the title. You went long-winded on that.
Ninja Innovation, it's the secrets, 10 secrets from the best companies in the world, the most innovative companies. Yeah, it was introduced in January. It's done really well. And it combines my knowledge of martial arts with what ninjas do with being around this industry for 3 decades and getting to know the leaders of every company. I talk about the companies that I admire and how they've reinvented themselves and what they've done, whether it's Amazon or IBM or Apple or others, and how they've really made a difference in technology. And I talk about smaller companies. And from that, you can say, what does it mean to be a ninja? Well, you have to be fast, smart, flexible, with a great team, and a lot of other cool things.
I really liked the book. You have a lot of great examples, like you mentioned. So you guys go check that out. And we also have, we'll put a link somewhere to an interview we did specifically on that topic. But for now, I kind of want to focus back here on the trends at CE Line shows. So we have seen a lot of health increase, you know, CES at the beginning of the year, health gadgets, fitness gadgets, they're really coming strong.
Absolutely. Wireless health and fitness is huge. It's a growing category for so many different reasons. One, the technology is there. There's different sensing devices, the MEMS, the microelectromechanical systems are huge, and they sense a lot of things about you. Two is getting to a doctor is a pain in the neck, and it's expensive. And with the new healthcare law coming, it's going to be even tougher. And so there's everyone agrees at this point, we have to start figuring out how you don't always go to a doctor to just check your vitals. So, but just be actually be pinged in a sense when you really have to go. And of course, everyone wants to talk about their own health, their own physical fitness, how much exercise you've done, how much you've consumed, whether it's Jillian Michaels, who's, yeah. I do her videos, I confess.
You do?
I totally, every weekend I'm doing a Jillian Michaels video.
That's awesome. John P's wife actually does them as well.
Well, and it he's so does
I could see
the females more, but it is
she was I'm not saying anything.
She was a CES, and you know they have the Body Fit, which actually measures how much exercise you do, and you can combine that with your calorie intake, and it's a phenomenal. But it's just one of several products. When I run, I have a different product and an app that measures my speed, and I have this little lady telling me that I'm going too slow in my head, and that's how it works. Is it, these things are good things for the most part, but I don't always use them, to be honest.
I'm doing a bunch of testing of those products. Usually I'm decked out in all the different ones I'm testing. So I've got like armbands, I've got heart rate monitors on, I've got all sorts of stuff going on. I'm enjoying them, but I think a lot of people, you know, have, they start out and then the motivation is a key factor in that, as it always has been in fitness.
It's still work. You have to do it. It's like all our technology. It's great. It's a great tool, yeah. But don't get obsessed with it. I'm a geek, but you know what? I don't have everything on all the time. I think you still need social interaction. You need live face-to-face meetings with people. Don't get so hooked up in your technology that you forgot that there's people there. You know, going to a restaurant and seeing families where everyone's playing video games or tweeting just turns me off, and I think we have to get away from that as a society. Speaking as a cheerleader for the technology industry, everything's about balance in life.
Understood. That is a very important message for sure. Speaking of getting to see each other in person, you are sitting down this week with somebody from Aereo.
Yes, Chad is the CEO and founder of Aereo, and I will be talking probably as this interview is airing Wednesday morning, and I will be interested in learning more about Aereo plans. As everyone knows, Aereo is a wonderful service that's in New York now only, I believe, which allows you to get the free over-the-air signal over the internet, which you're entitled to get for free, and it's been sued by all the major networks. It's very controversial. A couple of the network heads have said, if this is held legal, we won't have free over-the-air broadcasting. We're going to go to a subscription service. It's there's lawsuits all over the place, and it's something which is going to play out over time, but it's a really interesting service that gets you what you're entitled to get for free anyhow.
It's a very interesting service, as you said, but it's also a potentially very interesting market down the road once Aereo works out all of the kinks for everybody else. It'll be something to watch out for sure. And you guys will be able to get the information from Gary's talk, and we'll put links and all of that stuff at geekbeat.tv, so go check that out. Anything else we need to know from CE Line shows? Otherwise, I think I have to let you go, unfortunately.
It's a great week and a great event. And we'll go from this and finish up our preparations for January CES, where we'll see you again.
Indeed. All right. Thank you so much, Gary. We're going to finish getting set up. Has John done anything back there?
I'm gonna go help.
All right. Gary's going to go help. And-